5 startup lessons from the Young Rich List. This was a blog that I picked up. I think I picked it up from did print out where it's from. I'm pretty sure just by the type. Well, Oliver Millman is the author of this blog, and I believe I picked this up from an Australian website, startup something. It's a very, very good website. And I'm always enthused by lessons to be learned from young entrepreneurs. And these two individuals that they study are only in their 30s. And stopping for a moment, young Mark Zuckerberg, the founder of Facebook and the individual who built a company in May that was valued at $100 billion. Unfortunately for Mark and Wall Street, the business is only valued at $50 billion, half its value. Mark just celebrated his 28th birthday in May. Sergey Brin and Larry Page, the two major brains, if you will, behind Google, they are just in their 39th year, and look what they have built. As I say, I'm always enthused to read about lessons, something to be learned from young entrepreneurs. I've been doing this for 40 plus years, and I'm always trying to learn something new, and I've had tremendous amount of business experiences in those 40 years, but there's always something to be learned. And here's what these two gentlemen, Mike Cannon Brooks and Scott Farquhar, have a company that is now doing $480 million in sales. They amassed a fortune of $480 million. I'm not sure what they're doing in sales. Here's what they have to say. The tech sector is making its move. The tech sector will always be making its move. 3 years ago, almost 3 years ago, Curtis, my 25-year-old technology partner in David's Barter community, said to me, as a 22-year-old, I want to make $20 million. And I said, well, it's a doable goal. There are plenty of people that make $20 million in business. Plenty, and that list grows exponentially. And guess what? The folks that do it in the world of technology make it quicker, faster, better than anybody else, because technology is so very, very important to our lives. Our lives change every minute by some new technology innovation. And so if you want to make $20 million, a great place to make it is in technology. The other side of the equation is, if you can't make it in technology, I don't know an industry that is easy. If you can't make it in technology, you're going to be struggling to make $20 million in any other business venture. Starting lean can lead to huge rewards. It's always important to start lean and grow organically, grow naturally. That way your growth is going to be sustained. Your growth is going to be maintained. If you grow too fast, too quickly, many, many folks have found that they close their business doors. Startup growth from Australia, yes, the story came from Australia, remains a challenge. Startup Smart is the website where I got this information. It's a great website. I highly recommend you go there. I get something from them every single day. It's an Australian company that has developed the website, and they made the comment just the other day that the number of Australian startups is second only to the number of American startups. So there's lessons to be learned from American startups. There are lessons to be learned from Australian startups. Simple ideas win out with idea number four. Simple ideas will always win out. Simple execution of those ideas are even more important. Just because an idea is simple does not mean it's not important, does not mean it's not going to work. You have to be able to communicate simple ideas to the marketplace. If it is not perceived to be a simple idea, your ability to sell that idea, to market that idea, is going to be ever more challenging. Keep it simple. And the fifth thing is, don't act as if you know it all. That will turn people off to what it is that you're doing, what it is that you're trying to accomplish. Never appear to be a know-it-all, because there is nobody that knows it all. We all have our areas of expertise. We all have those areas that we need to excel in. But if you try to come off as an expert in everything, it's not going to work. And so develop a niche, develop a piece of something, and excel in that, and become the expert in that area, not a know-it-all, not an expert in everything we do. That's it for this segment. Thank you for your time. If you like what you heard, please share it with somebody else. Please take the time to come and register at davidsbarter.com. Register to become a part of our network of small businesses, folks who are starting a business. Exciting things are happening in the community. Join that and make them happen for you.